That is crazy. It's insane. It's kooky. It's wacko. It's conspiracy theory. You're spewing, you know, idiocy. That's because we have a belief system. Most people are, you know, good at heart. You know, they might be rotten bastards or whatever, but I mean, most people, at least in my view, and I believe this is true, that most people are inherently good, you know, and, or at least they're more good than bad. And we don't think like that. You know, why would they do that? Well, you know, I've already explained, it's about the green. You know, somebody is making money off of it. And those people don't care and think about anything or anybody except money. You know, the powers that be. The banksters, the corporate whores, you know. Who they are exactly, I don't even care. I mean, it's happening. And you'd have to be an idiot or a fool, or you'd have to have a blockage in your brain based upon your expectations, and that's called normalcy bias. Okay? Look it up. It's a normalcy bias. We expect things to be a certain way because that's the way we think. Anything which challenges your normalcy bias is refuted or, you know, blocked or, you know, somehow lessened in strength or value as far as, you know, information. And it isn't evaluated. It is, you know, it's, if it's outside of your belief system, you just, you know, your eyes start glazing over, and or you roll your eyes, and you know, or whatever, you're an idiot, you know. That's the thing. See, we got this normalcy bias, and we have this bias that, you know, people don't do stupid stuff like that just for money. Yeah, which is really, you know, naive and unrealistic. But we don't think like that. We don't think like, you know, serial murderers. We don't think like criminals. We don't think like the powers that be. We don't think like that. So, you know, when there's information out there about, you know, there's solid information and evidence, and, you know, it's even, you know, they got pictures, yeah, videos, and everything, and it's really pretty undeniable. But you'll totally reject this kind of information if it's outside of your belief system. What I want to do is just kind of, you know, ask you to, people as in general, you know, open your heart and open your mind to the truth, and it will set you free. And you'll get wise to the fact that everybody out there is not, you know, they're not your nanny. They're not wanting to take care of you. Homeland Security is not about terrorism. It's about putting you in a pen. Those kind of things, you know, the real truisms. You have to unblock your mind and open to the truth. Or when it's knocking at your door, you need to answer, you know. You see, we don't think that way. So, we're less likely to believe it. And, you know, I've kind of coined a phrase, You have to inundate to innovate. The thing is that, like, if information that you hear or see goes contrary to those beliefs and the things that you hold to be true, then it takes an awful lot of, you know, this contrary or, you know, information to hold any sway in your mind, because we are stubborn, we are beings of, you know, habit, and the way that we think is a habit, the way that we perceive the world around us has, you know, we have lived with ourselves our entire lives, so we have developed over time our belief systems and our beliefs, and they are very resistant to change. You know, the government knows this, but what they do is they hammer it in over and over, and it does take many, you know, exposures to infect you, more or less. But once it does, then it becomes increasingly difficult to change. This is how propaganda works, and this is what they've been doing to us in our minds with everything around you. You know, it's all about, you know, they know how you're psychology works, you know how the brain works to a certain extent, but the one thing they do know is if you tell a lie enough times, you'll believe it or you'll come to accept it as the truth. And that's what they do. They pound it in over and over again. Well, that's what we need to do to ourselves in order to expose and enlighten our minds with the truth. You know, we need to go out and search out these things, so-called conspiracies and whatever, and go out there and start learning about it. And pretty soon, all those information bits and bytes and what have you will probably break down your, you know, bias, normalcy bias, and your belief system, and you'll go, oh, well, I used to think that was crazy, but, you know, now I know it's just the truth. You know, so, you know, my point is, we don't think like they do, and thank God we don't, you know, because we're not criminals, we're not serial killers, we're not, you know, megalomaniacs, we're not, you know, lovers of money to that degree. We just, you know, we're just regular good old people. And they're counting on that, because they can pound their, what they call truth, into your head over and over, and by proxy and by insinuation and by context in TV shows and videos and commercials, and they can get you to think their way over time. So you have to know that. You have to know how they work, you know, and they don't do anything that they don't tell you they're gonna do. You know, they put it in open in some document or something somewhere, and I believe that's like a spiritual thing. Like the evil ones have to tell us what they're gonna do before they do it, so that there's no excuse for us not to understand or to realize. I don't know, that's just kind of an aside, and it's my opinion, but, you know, I watch Alex Jones, and I've been looking at a lot of stuff for a long time, and, you know, it's like Agenda 21. On the surface, looks great, you know, sounds good, environmentalism, yeah, you know. Freedom for and rights and you know, good things for minorities and women. Sure, that sounds great. look at my other video about agenda videos. I got a couple on Agenda 21. It's like that. It's their propaganda. It looks, it sounds, it smells, it tastes good. But what it is poison. It's poison of the brain, poison of your environment, poison of your entire world. And that's the kind of stuff we got. That's what's real. You know, chemtrails, hey, can you imagine the amount of aircraft fuel and toxic emissions that just the motors of the planes are producing when they're crisscrossing the sky? I mean, we're not talking about random, you know, flights across the, you know, anywhere. We're talking about, you know, there's like a fleet of these damn things going back and forth all the time. Look it up, you know, use your head. There's other things, you know, people don't really, you know, mention the fact that there's, you know, probably hundreds of these planes burning up carbon fuels and polluting the atmosphere with that every day, while they're poisoning the rest of the air and so-called geoengineering the planet. Now, by geoengineering, one has to come to the conclusion that it's geo-poisoning. And you can take it from this conspiracy theorist wacko. They ain't doing this to make anything good. Okay, so just as a, you know, summing it up, you know, we have a normalcy bias about how things are, the way things are and the way that we perceive them to be, and we're resistant to any change or alteration or any information which goes against that bias. And so it takes a whole lot of information or a whole lot of instances in which we're pounded in to understand or change or admit this information to processing in our brains. This is a psychological principle. It is a valid principle. Our environment all around us is full of toxic chemicals, radio waves, and powdered nanoparticulates, which get into our body and our environment, outside, inside, the soil, everything, and it is toxic and it is having negative effects, one of which may be a terrible memory. Which is what I started out with talking about. Oh yeah, I just remembered that. But, you know, think about it. Discuss it. Comment about it. Go look some stuff up and learn about some of the stuff out there that you currently or previously thought of was crazy, wacko, conspiracy theory. You know, some of the stuff out there is kind of crazy and wacko, you know, like alien stuff, whatever. But I can see where they might use such kind of things as a way to deceive you. And you have to think of it in that way. You have to think of it, well, you know, how are they deceiving me? And don't think about why. It's what are they doing and how are they doing it. That's what counts. The why you probably never will understand because you don't think that way. Understand? That's all I got to say for today. Except peace, love, and power. be to all the people, all the viewers. God bless.